Annual Sweetheart Manor Beauty Pageant. I'd like to take a minute to first off introduce our queen from last year, Miss Betty Stack.
Question number one, Miss Selma. What is the proudest moment of your life? proudest moment when I was in high school. I enjoyed sewing and English. I enjoyed English and sewing and music.
That's awesome.
That's great. Question number two. Who is your favorite entertainer?
Kenny Rogers.
Let's give a round of applause for Ms. Zelma LaFleur. For contestant number four, we'd like to welcome Ms. Callie McNeely. Ms. Callie is from England, Arkansas. Callie is a young 98 years old. She used to be an avid sewer, and she would sew all of her children's clothing. She's a proud mother of five. In her spare time, she enjoys going to church, spending time with family, this next part of life, and being a Chicago Cubs fan. Question number one, Miss Callie. Tell me about your hometown and what made it so special.
My life. It was really special.
That's wonderful. Question number two. Who influenced you the most growing up and why?
I don't know. My daddy and my daughter.
Okay. And what did they do to influence you?
They called me their baby.
That's wonderful. That's incredible. All right. Let's hear it for Ms. Callie. Ms. Chorsey Peter. Chorsey is from Helena, Arkansas. In her spare time, she enjoys doing word search puzzles, hanging with friends, and going to church. She is blessed with two grandsons and three granddaughters. Question number one, Ms. Chorsey. Who is your favorite entertainer? I'm glad I went. Question number two. Tell me about your hometown and what it made it so special. Oh, I just gave a song. This is Christian. I'm not your favorite anymore. I did wrong questions. I'm sorry. Okay. Tell me about your hometown and what made it so special.
Well, I live in Helton, Arkansas, and so I know about it, and I love it. The name of all my family was there, so I had a good time, blessed, and that's it.
That's great, Ms. Chorsey. Let's give it up for Ms. Chorsey. We have contestant number six. Everyone welcome Ms. Gloria. Gloria's hometown is right here in Little Rock. She enjoys hanging with her friends at the Manor, dancing, and going to church. She is heavily involved in the Zion Baptist Church and a proud mother of three. Question number one is Gloria. Can you define happiness for me?
Jesus.
Question number two. Describe yourself in three words.
An evangelist and counselor for the people in the spirit that I use a duty to.
That's me. All right, everybody, let's have a round of applause. Next up, we have Ms. Sarah Jones. Tennessee native. She is a talented quilter and loves to crochet and knit. In her spare time, she enjoys spending time with her great-grandkids and working on puzzles. Ms. Sarah, tell me three words your family would use to describe your character.
I go to church every Sunday. Mm-hmm. And when I was growing up, I went on Wednesdays. I don't get to go there. Wednesday.
Okay. Question number two. Tell me something interesting about your life you'd like the judges to know.
I was married 57 years to the sweetest man.
Miss Long is a young 99 years old. She won second place in the 2017 Senior Olympic Wheelchair Race. In her spare time, she enjoys coloring, spending time with family, and playing bingo. Miss Lorna, what is your secret to longevity?
What's your secret to living a long life?
Believing in God.
Question number two. What is your definition of success?
Good living.
Thank you so much. Let's have a round of applause for Ms. Lorna and all of while the judges are tallying up their scores, please feel free to grab a cookie and enjoy special music from Carol Dabney and Rob Ragsdale. Is Miss Mercedes Booth. Our second runner-up is Miss Sue Lynn. Our first runner-up is Miss Sarah Jones. Great job, Ms. Sarah. All right, everybody. The queen of the 2018 Manor Sweetheart Pageant is Ms. Chorsey Peter.
Wait, it ain't you. that done for me. No, I don't know what I would do without the Lord. He's my everything.
All right, we let our queen have her moment. All right, thank you everyone so much for coming, and thanks to our judges and our police officers who came. That was so great. And all of our family members who helped our residents get ready. Thank you.